You or your loved ones currently unemployed and looking for a job during this coronavirus pandemic? Would you like to learn easy but effective tips to help you get back into employment fast in 2020? If so, continue to watch until the end as you learn our 5 simple and easy tips to help you bounce back financially and help you get back into employment fast in 2020 during this COVID-19 pandemic. Hello, thanks for tuning in. I'm Sam Fortes Oliveira, founder of Success Booster Academy and author of Success Booster and also co-author of Bounce Back Stronger in 2020. Our mission and passion is not just to help you deal and overcome daily challenges and problems, but also to help you bounce back financially, mentally, and physically so you can become a better and stronger version of yourself. Our goal is to help you earn more, make more, and enjoy more. If you're new to this channel, consider subscribing and ring the notification bell below this video. If you do so, you're going to get free tips and tools to help not just to bounce back financially, but also to make more money and create a happy and fulfilled lifestyle, even in this tough time. Unfortunately, employment is rising and millions of people all over the world are losing their jobs and their main source of income. The current situation is very scary, but I think there is hope. So my question to you is, what can we do if we lose our job? Or what can we do if we are still working but are afraid of losing our job? What tips can you take to help you stay financially, mentally, physically, and even spiritually fit? That's exactly what we are going to talk about in this video. Before further ado, let's dive into the 5 things to help you bounce back financially after losing your job and get back into employment fast in 2020. Tip number 1 is to contact or connect with other professionals in your field. This is one of the best ways to find out what jobs are available right now. Ask yourself the following questions. Who have I worked well in the past? Who might be able to help me find your next job opportunity? Remember, it's not just about what they can offer, but also about what else they could connect you with. The people, the network. Remember, as they say, your network is your net worth. So make sure you're building the right network. Now, take a piece of paper and start making a list of all your former colleagues, managers, supervisors, clients, or suppliers. By the way, LinkedIn, if you're not aware of LinkedIn, is a brilliant resource for professional networking. Basically, it allows you to upload your CV, describe your experience and skills, and also it allows people to recommend your services. If you don't currently have a profile on LinkedIn, that should be your next priority. Many people call LinkedIn as a professional Facebook. If you need help to create a LinkedIn profile, let me know in the comments below and I'm happy to help you to set up this. Tip number 2 is to research jobs in high demand in your field. There are many companies that are still recruiting even during this pandemic. For example, some sectors such as the healthcare sector, the teaching sector, the public safety industry, including many others, still need professionals to fill positions. So if you have experience, passion, and skills in these sectors, I would highly recommend you to start applying for these jobs as soon as possible. But before you do, make sure you do the following things. 1, have the right CV. So make sure you tailor your CV and cover letter for the specific position you're applying for. Otherwise, you probably won't be offered an interview. Number two, don't waste your time looking for jobs in low demand or jobs that don't meet your needs. Just because we need a job to help us pay our bills, it doesn't mean we are going to get any type of jobs. So please don't do that. Now, number three is to get active on LinkedIn. Remember, LinkedIn is like professional Facebook, where you connect with like-minded professionals and people who share the same professional qualifications. Four is to be a good researcher. Remember, only research for jobs in high demand, because you don't want to be losing your time looking for jobs in low demand or jobs that don't meet your needs. And then five, use and leverage your personal relationships. For example, ask your friends, families, or anyone you know if they know someone who knows about jobs available. And then six is to improve your skills or learn new skills. Now, make sure those skills are related to the area you're interested in or the area you're passionate about. Or yet, make sure that the skills are in high demand right now, and also the skills are going to continue to be available, or if you like, are going to continue to be in demand in the future. Some examples of how you can improve your skills include reading books related to the area of interest. You can also invest your time in online courses. There are many online websites that provide free or very cheap courses, such as udemy.com, linkedin.com, read.co.uk, and many others. Another way you can improve your skills is to watch podcasts that specialize in specific topics you are passionate about or you're interested in. If you want to learn more about how to find the best jobs in demand right now, click on the top right corner of your screen. Are you enjoying this tip so far? If so, why not consider subscribing to our channel? We promise to give you the best tips and tools to help you not just to find your next job, but also to help you stay positive and motivated in this tough and challenging time. Now, tip number three to help you get back into employment fast in 2020 is to improve your job hunting skills. Job hunting takes time, and the amount of time you set aside for your search might not matter as much as how you prioritize your time. So if you are really serious about finding a new job, you should allocate part of each day to your search. But if you don't want to search for jobs every single day, you can allocate, let's say, 3 to 4 days of each week to focus on your job search. If you are struggling with your job hunting, you could always search for companies or charities that provide online job hunting support. For example, you could contact companies such as Institute of Personal Development and Career Coaching. That's my company, by the way. We provide affordable, tailored online training and coaching to young people and families from Black, Asian, and minority backgrounds. Additionally, you could check for support in your local area, in your library. You could also contact your local job center as they can help you with work experience. I know that, for example, job centers, they usually allocate a job coach, and their job is to help you get into work. So make sure you contact your local area, or if you like, get in touch with us, with my company, and I will be very happy to help you improve your job hunting skills and get back into work. Tip 4 is to ask for financial support. You might get entitled to certain benefits such as universal credit whilst you are hunting for a job. So make sure you contact your local citizen advice bureau to find out more information about this. Or you could also check the benefits calculator on the link below this video. If you have any trouble or problem filling the applications, you can ask for help from a friend or a family member. Alternatively, you can contact your local job center or citizen advice bureau to check if an agent can help you to fill applications or help you with any digital skills to fill these applications. You could also be entitled to redundancy payments if you lost your job. If you live in UK, go to www.gov.uk/redundancy, your rights, redundancy pay. I will list this. If you were made redundant on or after 6 April 2020, your weekly pay is capped at £538, and the maximum redundancy pay you can get is £16,140. But if you were made redundant before 6 April 2020, these amounts will be lower. So check that out. Now, if you're struggling with debts, I would recommend you to contact charities such as the Citizen Advice Bureau, which is a charity that helps people deal and overcome financial problems such as debt, welfare benefits, employment rights, and so on. Additionally, if you are struggling with debts, you could reduce your spending habits. You can sell anything you don't need anymore for additional money. You could call your creditors and negotiate better deals. If you want to know more about how to get out of debt and start saving more, click the top right corner of your screen. We did two videos, one about how to clear debt and another one on how to save more during a crisis. So make sure to check that out so you can learn more about how to get out of debt faster and also how to budget and save more money. Now, our tip number 5 is to keep a positive mindset. There is always hope. I always think that we should not allow our emotions to control us. We are emotional, but we don't have to allow our emotions to take control over our thoughts. We need to start managing these emotions instead of allowing these emotions to control us. But the truth is, when I lost my job, I felt a roller coaster of emotions. For example, I felt angry, a bit depressed, scared, and uncertain about the future. But you know what? After thinking about my life, I knew I could not dwell on these feelings, because the more I dwell on these feelings, the more I would block myself from finding new opportunities. So I have to let these emotions go so I can replace these emotions to better ones. Now, instead of focusing in fear or feelings of uncertainties, I took actions that allow me to keep positive and optimistic about the future. So if you're feeling like uncertain about the future, if you're feeling afraid or lost because you lost your job, I would say there is always hope. And what you have to do is to keep positive, keep motivated, because there is always new opportunities coming your way. So if you want to know more about how to stay positive during the tough time, check your top corner of the screen. We did a video about how to stay positive and motivated in tough times. So make sure to check that out. Now, these are our 5 tips to help you get back into employment fast and start earning more money. We hope these tools and strategies help you stay positive about the future, even in tough times. We hope that these tips help you to get back into employment so you can take control of your finances back. It's not about how many times we go down, but how many times we come back stronger after a fall. After all, challenges, crises, and pandemics are what make us grow and become stronger. Remember, it's impossible to thrive without experiencing challenges. If this video helped you in any way, please share, like, and subscribe to our channel. And also leave us a comment. Please share this video with only 3 people you know. It can help them to find the best job opportunities too. Do you want to know more tips and strategies to help you get back into employment fast in 2020? Then consider subscribing to our channel. We promise to give you the best tips to help you bounce back stronger in 2020, as well as to find the best job opportunities that fit your needs. Do you want to know how to find the best jobs or careers during the COVID-19? Or do you want to know how to deal with loss of income? Then click on the videos coming on your screen.